This is the Unstarving Musicians Podcast. The podcast features conversation for musicians of all types and genres, a curation of expertise intended to help all musicians be better at marketing, business, the creative process, and all the other things that empower us to do more of what we love, make music. Greetings, my like-minded, freaky little friends. This is Rapunzel, a.k.a. Roberto. This episode of the Unstarving Musicians podcast features yours truly in solo fashion. I'll be frank in telling you that putting together a weekly interview format podcast is challenging. Doable, but challenging. The challenge has been cat-herding of regular guests, and I've had a lot of wonderful people scheduled for the show. And continue to have some, but it occurred to me that maybe I'd want to do this solo gig once in a while, just in case. But next week, the podcast returns with another fascinating guest interview. I'm not going to tell you who it is, just because I want it to be a surprise, but you're going to be super excited. I think you're going to like it. So on with today's episode. I want to talk about a couple of things, the first of which is why networking is so important for musicians and totally worth it. So let's talk about my own experiences first. Visiting venues. This is something that I've done a lot, and it has paid off. If you're like me and enjoy wine or beer or eating, often these venues serve some of those things. Why not go and have a glass or a plate or something and pop in when the owner's there or your booking contact? Sitting in at open mic jams. I have done a fair amount of this. In more recent years, it's been to watch them because a friend is playing, but as you may know about me, if you've listened to this podcast or read my book, The Unstarving Musician's Guide to Getting Paid Gigs, you know that I found my way in the early years that I was in San Jose through a open blues jam hosted by Laura Price, whom I will talk more about in a few minutes. So these are great, a great way to meet other musicians, support other musicians, and let your talent be known, especially if you sit in. Another thing I've been involved in is going to and hosting events by and for other musicians. So let me tell you, musicians love getting together to talk about music stuff, business stuff, marketing stuff, and what a great way to make friends it has been for me. I co-hosted some events, for example, in the San Jose area. Maybe I'm rolling on 3 years now, with a friend there, and we both still have relationships with people who attended those small but wonderful events. And then actually all of this stuff has gotten me gigs and guests for podcasts. The networking I've done in the past and the networking I continue to do. So most of my guests, by the way, that have been on this podcast deliberately network. Laura Price, for example, who you can hear in episode 4 of this podcast, talks at length about her experience at the Blues Award, where she was nominated for Soul Blues Female Artist for the year of 2017. So it turns out that these awards ceremonies are not just parties. Laura, in fact, told me that these are networking events and very important ones. I know she had a good time there, but she told me that the people that she meets is absolutely priceless. She also made a little fun of a room full of musicians who were so often introverts, putting them in a place where they need to network or just kind of need to talk to one another. And she said can be a little funny, but she definitely makes the most of it. And if you watch her career or learn anything about her or know anything about her, Laura Price is... she's savvy. She's building her fan base, her music business, and a lot of that I know is through relationships and networking. Chris Responti, who you can hear in episode 2, he is the Texas guitarist, recording engineer, and songwriter who was featured in episode 2. He has flat out said networking and reputation is everything. Now, Chris has worked with people like the Dixie Chicks, Travis Tritt, Stan Lynch from Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. He's performed on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno, and his guitar work was featured on the theme track for HBO's True Blood. During his time in Nashville, and he did spend a little time there, I can tell he devoted a ton of time to relationships. I believe it was Chris that said, it's all about the hang. D. Grant Smith. new friend and host of the Appetizer Radio Show. You can check him out in episode 5 of this podcast. He helps musicians grow their fan base and careers through something he calls growth farming. And by the way, you can check out his radio show at appetizerradio.com. So he's all about relationships first and networking, some of it online and some of it offline. That means in person. He talks in detail about building relationships and when trying to get your music on radio. And oddly enough, he finds that some people don't think it's worth the time. Some people think that sending out a mass email campaign to a bunch of people they don't know is more effective. That they think that spraying at the wall and seeing what sticks is more effective. Well, D. Grant knows a lot of people in radio. He's been in radio for a long time, and he just flat out told me when he gets unsolicited stuff from people he doesn't know or didn't take any time to get to know anything about him or his audience, and that's all it takes. You don't have to personally know D. Grant Smith to get on the Appetizer Radio Show, which, by the way, features indie albums. You just have to show some interest when you contact him. Email is how he gets contacted, but when he gets emails that clearly indicate the person emailing knows nothing about his audience, him, his show, guess where they go? Yep, the trash. And guess what else? It works, this whole pretending like you care. Word gets around when people know and like you. D. Grant Smith talks about this. I think everybody who's been on my podcast understands that. Most of my musician friends understand that. D. Grant Smith also, by the way, he has a book called The DIY Musician's Radio Handbook, How to Hack Your Fan Base and Build Stronger Networks Using Indie Radio Airplay. I'll put that in the show notes. It's also in the show notes of episode 5, but I just thought I'd mention it because I was sure you'd want to know about that if you're trying to get your music on radio. Excuse me while I have a sip of coffee. Oh, good stuff. It is morning here in Panama. I forgot to say I'm broadcasting from, I'm recording from Panama, the rural interior, or the jungle, as I like to call it, of El Valle de Anton, which, for those of you who are gringos, that is the Anton Valley. All right, on with the topic of networking and relationships. So John Wolfe, speaking of Panama, John Wolfe is the organizer of the Boquete Jazz and Blues Festival, the biggest little festival on the planet. It is held here in Panama annually. It's growing like a weed, and I mean in a good way. When I asked him how he screens for performers, for acts that are going to be part of that festival, the very first thing he said, I think it was the very first, was through referrals and recommendations. Now, he says he looks for non-high-maintenance musicians. He needs people that are flexible, will go with the flow, and are just open to working with other musicians because that festival's about those things. He's always had his pulse on music all his life is another thing he said. What does that mean? To me, that means he's always had a high interest in music, and he's always taken a high interest in people that are in music. That means he was nurturing relationships all of his life to keep his pulse on music. But going back to what he first said, that he gets most of his acts through referrals and recommendations, how amazing is that? He does that because he has close relationships with people. He's constantly expanding that close circle of relationships, and that all happens through networking, my friends. So Jim Kisselberg, he's a longtime friend who was featured in episode 7. He is a fellow Texan. I say I'm a Texan. Refer to myself as a Texan because I was born in Fort Worth, Texas, where I lived until 99 and where I met my loving wife, Sammy. But Jim and I were in a band long ago. But today, these days, he told me that he very effectively uses videos to market his cover band. But he says relationships are first when it comes to venues. And he told me that point blank when I talked to him about the marketing aspect of what he does. Paul Kent, who was featured in episode 9, he is another friend of mine from Northern California. He's co-host of Gig Gab, the Working Musicians podcast, which you can find at giggabpodcast.com. He's also co-organizer of a San Francisco South Bay event called the Los Gatos Music in the Park series, or just Los Gatos Music in the Park. Huge event, widely attended. He's also ringleader for an 11-man powerhouse band called the House Rockers. What I wanted to mention about Paul, other than the fact that he's a master at relationships, is he hosts an annual holiday happy hour for all of his local musician friends and acquaintances in the Bay Area there of Northern California. I've been to a couple of these events. I believe it was a couple. I got to know him because he spoke at one of those aforementioned small events for musicians. I received regular invitations, possibly following that event that he spoke at. But Paul does this to bring us all together to keep our relationships intact, make new friends, because there's a lot of people that attend this. The last one that I attended, there were people I knew of, some of whom I recognized, some of whom I didn't recognize, and there were a few very close friends there too, but it was a great way to get your face out, to get my face out, and for all of us to get our faces out in front of others. So Paul definitely understands networking. Now, the other thing is that all of these guests that I've mentioned preach, and in fact, I think all of my guests preach showing up, doing the work, and being a nice person. But this networking stuff, it's huge. So if you're not doing it, think about doing it. And you know what? To make it easier on yourself, if you're an introvert, just go out and talk to everyone like they're a really good friend, and it'll make life a lot easier, even if it's somebody new. But we're going to talk a little bit about how you can do that here in the next part. So again, everyone talks about doing the work, showing up, and being a nice person. So that leads me into the second topic I wanted to talk about, which is why helping other musicians matters. And not just other musicians, but people in general, people in the music business, people outside of the music business, and why it matters so much to us as musicians and artists. So I wrote about this in my book, again, The Unstarving Musician's Guide to Getting Paid Gigs, which you can get on Amazon, which will be featured in the show notes, and is pretty much featured in the show notes of every show. I've spoken with others about this, both for that book and for this podcast, and they echo this sentiment of helping others. They get it, probably because they're people I know and they're like-minded. But some personal examples here. So I have referred bands other than my own to venues that I have played or that I wanted to play and maybe haven't even played yet. Doing that has scored me huge points with venues and almost always inevitably got me a gig, particularly if I wanted a gig there. I've referred musician bands to friends in need, and I'm talking a drummer referring other drummers. And I've had this done to me. One of my good friends told me jokingly once, I think half jokingly, he referred me to a regular gig, which was pretty cool, a paying gig. He just told me once, you stole my gig. So for whatever reason, they started hiring me. I think it was just for some of the gigs, not because I'm better. I think I just fit a few of the gigs based on my interest in music, perhaps my style, but he wasn't mad at me. That I think, you know, the point is that there's plenty of gigs for everyone. I have one close friend who's reached out to a few people on my behalf. Actually, it's the same friend I was referring to. He's reached out to a few people on my behalf to recommend that they do a guest spot on my podcast. That is very cool. And these people he's referred me to, they are very interesting folks. So because of him and because he's in the helping, giving spirit and because we're close friends, he's going to get us some good interviews. And I talk about us, I'm talking about you and me, listener, that we will get to hear and learn from. All of my guests have referred me to other prospective guests, which is very cool. Now I always ask, but a lot of times they just flat out recommend it without me before I even get to the point of asking. So why do we do this and why do I think it's so important? Well, here's what I think. Because it feels good to help others, because we want others to succeed, and because we want to pay it forward, so to speak. And finally, because others have and would do the same for us. I firmly believe that. Some people are better at this than others. In fact, the friend I was just talking about, he is so great about connecting people. I'm known as a connector in my circles as well, but I feel like this friend I was talking about, who you're going to meet soon on a podcast interview, I feel like he is one of the greatest connectors of my life. I don't know. He told me recently, it's just how his brain works. But there are a lot of little things that we can do to help others. We don't have to be some kind of master connector. We don't always have to be making introductions. But that's what I want this podcast to be about, musicians helping musicians. Just remember, there's plenty of gigs, plenty of work, and opportunity for all of us. So realize this and your world, our world, opens up to limitless possibilities. So it matters that you help others. It matters that others help you. It matters that we help one another. So I hope I'm not stating the obvious to you, and if I am, may it simply serve as a little reminder for you to get out there and serve others when the opportunity arises. Thank you so much for tuning in and listening to my rant. Please join me again next week as I have another interview that I think you're going to enjoy. No, I know you're going to enjoy it. And please remember to subscribe to this podcast on iTunes or wherever you get your podcast. And if you enjoy it, pretty please take a moment to give it a review. I would be forever grateful. Peace, love, and more cowbell. Hey, this is Robonzo. Thanks so much for listening. Did you know I'm also an author? Check out my book, The Unstarving Musician's Guide to Getting Paid Gigs, How to Get Booked and Paid What You're Worth Over and Over Again, available on Amazon. And the book is also available in audio format as The Unstarving Musician's Guide podcast. Check it out wherever you get your favorite podcasts. Last but not least, are you a gigging musician, recording artist, songwriter, or touring professional? Perhaps struggling to get your music out to the world? Struggling to get the gigs you want? Pop over to unstarvingmusician.com and sign up for my email list. I'll send you an occasional email with tips, expert advice, music, musician resources, and anything else I come across that might make your journey better and brighter. With much gratitude, peace, love, and more cowbell.